See, this is the definition of EAT capacity. Okay, what is the EAT capacity? See, the amount of EAT is required to increase, the amount of EAT is required to increase 1 degree temperature to a substance is called EAT capacity. Okay, the EAT capacity denoted by the capital letter. Why we are taking this is a first letter means, see, why we are taking capital H means already it is there in the heat capacity. What is the first letter in the heat? H is there. Due to that, we are taking the heat capacity denoted by the H symbol. So, according to definition, see, observe. What happened here? The amount of heat is required. Already I said, heat, which letter we are denoting, representing? In general, we are devoting. How we are measuring heat? Calories. In the, what is the first letter in the calorie? Q. So, let us take that is the heat means we can take the Q letter. So, what happened here? See, all of you, this is very, very important. From that, we can write the mathematical formula. So, what happened? The amount of heat is required to increase. What is the next one? Temperature. To substance, that may be any substance, that may be solid, that may be liquid, that may be gas, depend upon your substance you can take. So now we are going to write the mathematical formula for heat capacity. Mathematical formula for heat capacity. Okay, but I said which letter we are denoting heat capacity? H we are denoting. Okay, are you considering total energy or small energy? Okay, you are considering at certain some amount. That we can take, that's what is the first letter here? Q letter is there. That's why we are writing here dq by dt. Okay, this is the mathematical formula for heat capacity. What happened? H is equal to dq by dt. Or else sometime we can write like this also. H is equal to delta Q by delta T. What is the Q? Heat is. Heat we are applying. Then what happened? Automatically temperature will be increasing. Then we are saying that is the heat capacity. Okay. Next one. Specific heat capacity. Same formula will be exist. Not same. Same definition will be there. Here. Heat capacity. Specific heat capacity. Next one. Second one. Specific heat capacity. Okay, in the specific heat capacity, what is the first letter here? S is there. That's why we are denoting the specific heat capacity. Okay, see, same thing, same definition will be exist, small change will be there. Specific is there due to that what we are using here. See, the amount of heat is required to increase 1 degree centigrade temperature. At the temperature, what are you doing? 1 unit of mass of a two substance. What did I write here? Temperature. 1 unit of mass. 1 unit mass of substance. Substance is called specific heat capacity. Okay, this is denoted by symbol C. S is there. Okay, mathematical formula for specific heat capacity. So, what is the definition? The amount of heat is required to increase 1 degree temperature, 1 unit of mass. Substance is called specific heat capacity. Which letter we are denoting specific heat? okay, here first letter specific started the S letter. Due to that, we are considering the S letter. Okay, now we are going to write the mathematical formula for specific heat. Okay, what is there here? See. Same formula previously, what is that? H is equal to dq by dt. Here also same thing will be there, dq by dt will be there. Okay, from temperature, what is happening? 1 unit of mass you are taking. What are taking? 1 unit of mass. Due to that, we are getting simple one extra term. What is the formula for this? Specific heat capacity. S is equal to 1 by m dq by dt. Or else another formula also you can write. What I can write? S is equal to, when you are solving problem, definitely you have to consider like this, dq by dt you can take. What is the delta means? Nothing but delta means change. Okay, one initial to final or final to, sorry, final minus initial. Delta means change in heat. Temperature means change in temperatures. So what is the formula for finally specific heat capacity? S is equal to 1 by m dq by dt. Next one. Same, specific heat capacity. Okay, now next one is there, molar specific heat capacity. Same thing, you have to add one word here. What is that? Molar specific heat capacity. Okay, molar specific heat capacity means, see. Okay, the amount of heat is required to increase 1 degree temperature 1 mole of gas. Or 1 gram mole of gas. 1 gram mole of gas is called So this letter, what is the first letter here? Here also we can say molar means, say let us take you are having the ideal gas equation. What is the ideal gas equation? PV is equal to N RT. What is the N here? Mole. Okay, N, if you take N is equal to 1 mole, N is equal to 2 mole, like that you can say. The, again here also, molar specific heat also, same thing will be there. Instead of here M, what you are getting here? Same letter. So heat capacity, sorry, this molar capacity also denoted by the S letter only. Next, mathematical formula for molar specific heat capacity. Yes, we are denoting. So what is changing here? What is the real word? 1 gram mole is there. Due to that, mole, what you have to take here later? I said here, N is equal to mole you have to take. Okay, simply what is the formula? 1 by N. Okay, what is the formula for molar specific heat capacity? S is equal to 1 by N dq by dt. Okay, these are the three main definition. What is the first? Heat capacity. Next, second one, see. Heat capacity, first one. Next, what I added extra? Next, specific heat I added. Here to here, H. Next, here to here, S. Next, here to here also, S will be there. So, these are the three definitions. What is the first one? See, H is equal to, what is that formula? dq by dt. Next, what happened? S is equal to 1 by m dq by dt. Capital letter you can take. So next one, what happened next one? Molar is there. 1 by n is equal to dq by dt. These are the three definitions are very, very important. So h is equal to dq by dt, s is equal to 1 by m dq by dt, s is equal to 1 by n dq by dt. Okay, next, last one is there, the specific. Okay, if you want to get measurements also you can write. What is this? How we are measuring heat? Joules. Okay, how we are measuring temperatures? Joules also, calories also we can measure. Joules we can measure, then calories also we can measure. So time, how we are measuring, time, how we are measuring temperature? Kelvins. This is not time, this is temperature. So here also same thing will be there, here also same thing. Here what is there? Kg will get, mass we are taking. So what happened here? Joule by kg by next Kelvin. So here moles. So there is no formula for mole only, mole will come. What happened here? Joule by next Kelvin by mole. These are the measurements. So H is equal to the formula, dq by dt is equal to joule by Kelvin. Next S is equal to 1 by m dq by dt, dq joule. Next mass, how we are measuring? Kgs, mks unit or SI unit. Next S is equal to 1 by n dq by dt. N is equal to what is this? Mole, mole, not mele, mole, mole, joule by Kelvin. Okay, these are the measurements. Okay, these are main capacities. Okay, last one is there, specific heat of gases. Very, very important. Okay, next one, specific heat of gases. Okay, the gases, especially there are two types of specific heat of gases. Okay, what happened? What I said two words. What is the first one? Volume. Next, what is the second one? Pressure. Okay, these are the two words are there. Okay, specific heat of gases, this is divided into two types. Okay, depend upon their particle nature, inside particles are there. Due to that, what we can say, the first one, okay, specific heat at constant volume. Next, another one, specific heat of gas at constant pressure. These are the two types. What happens? Specific heat of gases. Okay, suppose let us take, if I consider ammonia gases, carbon dioxide gases, can you give some example gases? Nitrogen gas, oxygen gas, next carbon dioxide gas. These are the gases. Okay, gas. Okay, heat. Okay, if I give, okay, this gas is at a normal temperature, room temperature. Okay, now if you supply heat, what happen? Automatically the particles will move around the four walls. Okay, they will gain some energy. What happen? Due to that, they want to go outside from this place to that place. Okay, if chance is there, then automatically the particle move from this room to another room. Okay, next, specific. Okay, specific means at a particular point. Then we can say that is the specific heat of gases. Okay, automatically we can say that is the two types in general. What we can say, specific heat of gas at constant volume. Next one, first one I am writing here. Constant volume. Next one. Constant pressure. Okay. Specific heat constants. Okay, we are having two constants. Always we are taking the constant C. Here also we can take the C. Okay, what is there here? Constant. What is the, which one is constant? V. Here which one is constant? P. Okay, what you are getting? C suffix V. What you are getting here? C suffix V. Okay, what is that? Constant volume. At the constant pressure. Okay, next we are defining that. We are going to define that CV and next CP. Okay, after that we will derive the CV and CP relations. Okay.